It is amazing living in a big city. People in big cities live a hectic life. They are busy with their work, busy improving lifestyles for themselves and their families, wanting to secure bright futures for their children, providing them the best education so one day they are able to sustain a respectful, dignified life. Looking at these cities with height-obsessed skylines that are indeed modern architectural marvels, one realizes how quickly luxuries become necessities. But not very far from these skylines, just outside the edge of these large urban setups, there are places where even the basic necessities are the unaffordable luxuries. These are the places where a three-day meal is a real blessing and a child attending school a miracle. Patoki is a typical Punjabi rural town on the outskirts of Lahore, which plays a major part in the expansion of the awe-inspiring skyscrapers merely by contributing the basic building block, brick. Furnaces of these brick kilns are burning. Smoke is bellowing out of the chimneys of the kilns and the workers are constantly working from dusk till dawn and same all over again. These brick kilns often employ the poorest, most vulnerable and disadvantaged people from our society. These can be men, women, elderly and the children. Plentiful clay, fine sand and water are the common ingredients of brick and land of Punjab, which has the highest concentration of brick kilns with respect to other provinces. The remaining three provinces together may have around 1,000 kilns with over 400 in the NWFP. In a cold, hazy winter morning, Bashir Masih and his family is getting ready for their routine task. A task that they are doing for the last 30 years. Brick making is essentially a part of their life, a very important part on which their survival depends. The hands moulding earth into strong bricks are wary with intensive work in conditions that are harsh and ruthless. In fact, sometimes also chained in virtual slavery. Physical and mental cost that brick kiln workers pay is high, and the return of this is only their survival, two times meal to keep their body and soul together.
ਇਹ ਬੜੀ ਵੱਡੀ ਐ ਇਸ ਕੰਮ ਦੀ ਲਾਨਤ ਹੈ ਤੇ ਜਿੰਨਾ ਮਰਜ਼ੀ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਓ ਰੋਟੀ ਮੋੜ ਵੀ ਮਿਰਚਾਂ ਨੇ ਖਾਣੀ ਤੇ ਹੁਣ ਮੈਂ ਇਹ ਕਾਰੋਬਾਰ ਕਰਨਾ ਜੀ ਹੁਣ ਕਈ ਦਾ ਮੇਰਾ ਕੋਈ ਮੌਲਤ ਨਹੀਂ ਨਾ ਜੀ ਹੈਗਾ ਮੈਂ ਦੋ ਤਰੇ ਪੋਤਰੇ ਵਾਲਾ ਹੈਗਾ ਤੇ ਸਿਰਫ ਇਹ ਮਜਬੂਰੀ ਆ ਵੀ
ਕੋਈ ਬੁਖਾਰ ਚੜ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਕਦੀ ਜਿਸਮ ਦੁਖਦੇ ਕਿਸੇ ਦਾ ਗੋਡਾ ਦੁਖਦਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਦਾ ਸਿਰ ਦੁਖਦਾ ਬਸ ਇਸੇ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਬਸ ਦਵਾਈ ਦੁਈ ਖਾ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਨੇ ਫੇਰ ਕੰਮ
ਪ੍ਰੋਵਾਈਡਿੰਗ ਫਾਰ ਦੀ ਐਵਰ ਇਨਕਰੀਜ਼ਿੰਗ ਡਿਮਾਂਡਸ ਆਫ ਦ ਇਮਰਜਿੰਗ ਮਾਡਰਨ ਸਿਟੀਜ਼ ਦ ਸੈਂਚਰੀਜ਼ ਓਲਡ ਟ੍ਰੈਡੀਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਬੌਂਡਡ ਲੇਬਰ ਕੰਟੀਨਿਊਜ਼ ਟੂ ਲਿਵ ਔਨ ਇਨ ਬ੍ਰਿਕ ਕਿਲਨ ਇੰਡਸਟਰੀ
In Pakistan, we have a specific definition of the bonded labor, the definition was given by our parliament in 1992 in a particular law. Practically, we follow the definition of the other normal jurisdiction in the neighboring countries. It is a very lengthy definition. The ingredients of a definition which makes the bonded labor is if somebody takes some advance loan for his family or for himself, and in lieu of it, in consideration for that, he, she or his family is a bonded, they cannot move, they have to work there for a particular period, they cannot sell their produce. So all those forms of a slavery-like practices are considered as a bonded labor.
You see, if a person is engaged to work or offers to work for another person without a wage or for a wage which is lower than the standard wage and is not free to change his employment or is not free to change his place of living and is obliged to accept whatever conditions are imposed on him, then that person is considered as a bonded laborer.
ਇਹ ਪੇਸ਼ਗੀ ਸਿਸਟਮ ਪਾਈ ਹੈ ਸਾਡੀ ਪੇਸ਼ਗੀ ਲੈਣਾ ਮਜਬੂਰੀ ਹੈ ਅਸੀਂ ਲਈਏ ਸਾਡਾ ਸਰਦਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਮਹਿੰਗਾਈ ਇੰਨੀ
ਇਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਕਰਜ਼ੇ ਕੁਰਜ਼ੇ ਖਾਣ ਪੀਣ ਦੇ ਚੜ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਨੇ ਉਹ ਫਿਰ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਪੂਰਾ ਸਾਲ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੰਮ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਪੈਸੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਲੈਂਦੇ
ਇਹ ਪੈਸੇ ਲੈਣੇ ਸਾਡੀ ਮਜਬੂਰੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੋਈ ਚਾਹ ਨਾ ਲੈ ਹੁਣ ਇਹ ਮੇਰੇ ਤੇ ਲੱਖ ਰੁਪਈਆ ਚਾਰ ਮੇਰੀਆਂ ਭੈਣਾਂ ਜਵਾਨ ਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਸ਼ਾਦੀ ਵੀ ਕਰਨੀ ਕੋਈ ਜਗ੍ਹਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੋਈ ਕੁਛ ਨਹੀਂ
ਉਹ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਪੈਸੇ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਾ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਇਹ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੀ ਉਹ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਪੈਸੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਾ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਜੀ ਉਹ ਫਿਰ ਉਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਇਹ ਹੈ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਰਦੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਥੋੜ੍ਹਾ ਘਟਾਉਂਦੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਕੁਛ ਲੈਂਦੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ
ਇੱਥੋਂ ਉੱਠਣਾ ਹੋਵੇ ਨਾ ਆਦਮੀ ਨੇ ਇਸ ਪੱਠੇ ਤੋਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਪੈਸੇ ਦੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਅਗਲੇ ਪੱਠੇ 'ਤੇ ਚਲੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ 10,000-12,000 ਉੱਪਰ ਚੜ੍ਹ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਉਹ ਫਿਰ ਇਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਸਰੌਲੇ ਹੌਲੀ ਵੱਧ ਜਾਂਦੇ
ਵੀ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਦੇਣੇ ਨੇ ਨਾ ਅਤੇ ਉਹ ਦੇ ਦੇਣਗੇ ਨਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਉਹ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੇ ਹੋ ਜਾਵਾਂਗੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਰਹਿਸ਼ ਦੇ ਦੇਣਗੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਕੀਤੀ ਰੱਖਾਂਗੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਪੈਸੇ ਫਿਰ ਉਹ ਉੱਧਰ ਚਲੇ ਜਾਣਗੇ ਭਰਨੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕੋਈ ਸਾਡੇ ਕੋਲ ਤਾਂ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੀ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੋਲੋਂ ਦੇ ਦਈਏ ਉਹ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਰੀਦੇ ਜਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਵਿਕੇ 'ਚ ਫਿਰਨੇ ਹਾਂ ਅਤੇ ਖਰੀਦ ਵੀ ਇੱਕ ਮਸਾਲੇ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਇੱਕ ਪੱਠਾ ਹੈ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਅੱਗੋਂ ਖਰੀਦਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਵੀ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਜਵਾਬ ਦੇ ਦਿੱਤਾ ਉਹ ਭਰ ਗਏ ਰੁਪਈਏ ਅਤੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਉੱਥੇ ਲੈ ਗਏ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਕੰਮ ਕੀਤਾ ਗਿਆ ਜੀ
ਇਹ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਮੁਨਸ਼ੀ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਨਾ ਹਫ਼ਤੇ ਨੂੰ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦੇ ਉਹਨੇ ਖਰਚੇ ਬਣਾਏ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਵੀ ਇੰਨੀ ਫਲਾਣੇ ਦੀ ਇੰਨੀ ਫਲਾਣੇ ਦੀ ਅਤੇ ਮੁਨਸ਼ੀ ਦੇ ਸਿਰ 'ਤੇ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਉਹਨੇ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਇੰਨਾ ਫਲਾਣੇ ਦਾ ਖਰਚਾ ਇੰਨਾ ਫਲਾਣੇ ਦਾ ਖਰਚਾ ਹੋਰ ਇਹ ਖਾਤੇ ਖੋਤੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਵੇਖਦੇ ਅਤੇ ਨਾ ਹੀ ਉਹ ਵਹਾਂਦੇ ਹੀ ਨੇ ਖਾਤੇ
ਅਸੀਂ ਸਰ ਜੀ ਨਪੜ ਲੋਕ ਹਾਂ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਇਹ ਸਮਝ ਨਹੀਂ ਲੱਗਦੀ ਵੀ ਇਹ ਕੀ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਜਾਂ ਕਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਇਹ ਸਾਰੇ ਮੁਨਸ਼ੀਆਂ ਦਾ ਹਿਸਾਬ ਕਿਤਾਬ ਹੁੰਦਾ ਹੈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਕਰਨਾ ਹੈ ਅਤੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਤਾਂ ਪਤਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਕੀ ਲਿਖ ਦਿੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਕੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਲਿਖਦੇ ਇਹਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਸਾਡਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਰੌਲਾ ਵੀ ਪਾਈ ਜਾਈਏ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਈ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਆਪ ਹੀ ਸੱਚੇ ਰਹਿਣਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਝੂਠੇ ਝੂਠੇ ਹਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਜ਼ਿਆਦਾ ਬੰਦਾ ਗੱਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰ ਸਕਦਾ ਕਿਉਂਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਪੈਸੇ ਦੇਣੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਆ ਅਤੇ ਉਹਦੀ ਵਜ੍ਹਾ ਤੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਪ੍ਰੈਸ਼ਰ ਨਾਲ ਗੱਲ ਨਹੀਂ ਕਰ ਸਕਦੇ
However, employers of the brick kiln industry have their own point of view.
50 lakh se 1 crore rupaya advance dena padta hai. Sabse badi investment bhatta malik ki wo advance hai jo labor ko dena padta hai. Iske baghair kaam nahi hota. Maine 20 dafa NGOs ko aur tamam logon ko challenge kiya ki mere paas ek bhatta pada hai. Isliye band hua hai ki humne peshgi nahi di. तो लोग चले गए हमसे आप लोग आए और मुझे फ्री लेबर दे दें जो पैसे एडवांस न ले रेट जो है अगर 400 रुपए में 500 दूंगा और आप मेरे पास काम करें पैसे एडवांस नहीं ने इन्वेस्टमेंट इसकी जो सबसे बढ़िया बटे में वो है जो एडवांस लोग देते हैं अब इतनी बड़ी एडवांस लोग इसलिए तो नहीं देते कि वो लेबर को मारेंगे बांधेंगे और या उनके साथ कोई ज्यादती करेंगे या उनको ज़बरदस्ती उनसे काम कराएंगे इसलिए नहीं देते लोग अपना बिजनेस चलाने के लिए इतनी बड़ी इन्वेस्टमेंट करते हैं
यहाँ पे जो बॉन्डेज है वो म्यूचुअल है जो वर्कर है स्पेशली भट्ठे वाला ब्रिकलिंस का उसने एडवांस लिया होता है पेशगी ली होती है और उस पेशगी लेने की वजह से वो पाबंद होता है उस भट्ठे पर काम करने के तो जब इन दोनों की एम्प्लॉयर का और वर्कर का आपस में म्यूचुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग के साथ ये काम हो रहा होता है तो आप इसको उस सेंस में जबरी नहीं कह सकते जैसे कि इसके डिक्शनरी टर्म।
वर्कर्स अंडर वेयरिंग सर्कमस्टेंसेस बार्टर देयर लाइव्स इन एक्सचेंज ऑफ ट्रिवियल डेट्स। They simply opt for this form of labor as a way of meeting their financial crises that may arise on a funeral, birth of a baby, a marriage, or even to afford medical expenses in severe health conditions. Like many other poor Brick Kiln workers who usually get entrapped into debt on occasions of vital events of life, Bashir took loan from his owner.
मजबूरी फिर इदा ही आ कोई बच्ची का विआह किया मुड़ के बच्चे का एक्सीडेंट हो गया ये फिर तीन चार महीने अस्पताल जनाह रखा उत्थे फिर चुक चुक पैसे लाते रहे फिर इदे पैसे चढ़ते चढ़ जाते।
Despite the tiresome effort he put in his whole life, he does not find any way to get out of it.
पेचकी ते पैसे दिते ही खत्म होंगी है जी उवें ते नहीं होंगी पैसे पवां जो कोई जगह हैगी वह वेच लो जो कोई डंगर बच्छा हैगा वह वेच के पैसे दे दो फिर ही खत्म होंगी है जी।
Their bodies exhaust and sweat, but this debt does not decrease. There might be another event in life for which they need an additional loan.
ਪੇਸ਼ਕੀ ਜੀ ਇਹ ਕੋਈ ਬੱਚੀ ਦਾ ਕਰਨਾ ਹੋਵੇ ਤੇ ਫੜਨੇ ਪੈ ਜਾਂਦਾ ਚਲੋ ਜੀ 10,000 ਕੋਈ ਬਿਮਾਰ ਹੋ ਗਿਆ
ਕੱਲ ਬੱਚੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਬਿਮਾਰ ਹੋ ਗਈ 10-12,000 ਰੁਪਇਆ ਫੜਨਾ ਪੈ ਗਿਆ
ਲਾਹੌਰ ਜੀ ਉਹ ਲਾਹੌਰ
ਦੱਸਿਆ ਹਸਪਤਾਲ ਪਰ ਉੱਥੇ ਦਾਖਲ ਕੀਤੀ ਮਜਬੂਰੀ ਨਾਲ ਲੈਣੇ ਪੈਂਦੇ ਨੇ।
When we say that debt bondage is centuries old and unfinished business even in today's era, it is because this menace is passed from one generation to another.
इस तरह ही जी अज नहीं लथी तो अगले साल उदू अगले साल हम सू इत 20 साल हो गए तो बस पेशगी वही जाती घर के खर्चे नहीं पूरे होंगे तो करिए कि महंगाई बड़ी
ये अरसे तो मेरा प्यो भी इस काम से फौत हो गया तो अगो अभी भी ये कर।
Knowing not for how long, they just work day in and day out at the same kiln, paying off the ever increasing debt that their ancestors may have borrowed. It is only brought to light when Darshan Masih wrote a telegram to the Supreme Court of Pakistan in 1988.
Now, Darshan Masih case only drew attention to bonded labor on brick kilns, you know. He filed a petition and requested court intervention in a case of debt bondage. It was said that the brick kiln owners advanced money called peshgi against the wages to be earned in future, and these advances became so enormous because the laborer did not know how to keep accounts. He didn't know the accounts were inflated. So the court declared that this is illegal.
As a result of the telegram written back then, the Chief Justice of Pakistan ordered a complete investigation of the case and passed the landmark ruling against Jamadari system, which from there on led to a revolutionary movement against bonded labor. The bonds of slavery run deep. The practice does not only have economic implications, but in many cases it limits the bonded laborers and their families to seek alternative employment to pay off their debts.
ਕੀ ਸੋਚਣਾ ਸੀ ਜੀ ਜਨਾਬ ਇਹ ਨਾ ਜੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਇਹ ਕਾਰੋਬਾਰ ਕਰਨੇ ਤੇ ਆਪਾਂ ਬੱਚੇ ਵੀ ਸਾਡੇ ਇਹ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ ਇਹਨੇ ਕਰਜੇ ਥੱਲੇ ਨੱਪੇ ਆ
ਤੇ ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਵੀ ਕਰਨਾ
ਜੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਨਾ ਹੀ ਨੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਆਪੇ ਬੱਚੇ ਵੀ ਨਾ ਕਰਨ ਦੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਵੀ ਨਾ ਕਰਕੇ ਮਜਬੂਰੀ ਨਾਲ ਕਰਨਾ ਪੈਂਦਾ ਜੀ
ਉਹ ਜੀ ਕਰ ਤਾਂ ਲਈਏ ਜੇ ਇੱਧਰੋਂ ਸਾਡੀ ਝੁੰਡ ਛੁੱਟੇ ਤਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਹੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਰਨੇ ਹਨ ਜੇ ਇੱਧਰਲੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਫਰਕ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ ਕੋਲੋਂ ਫਿਰ ਹੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਦੁਕਾਨ ਵੀ ਚਲਾ ਸਕਾਂਗੇ ਜਦੋਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੱਥੇ ਆਖਾਂਗੇ ਮਾਲਕ ਨੂੰ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਚੱਲੇ ਹਾਂ ਤਾਂ ਉਹਨੇ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਦਿੱਤੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਾਧੇ ਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਹਨੂੰ ਤਾਂ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਕੇ ਉਹਨੇ ਜਾਣੇ ਨੇ ਅਸੀਂ ਉੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਨਹੀਂ ਜਾ ਸਕਦੇ ਉਸ ਤਰੀਕੇ।
Hence, taking away their freedom of mobility, freedom of association, freedom to negotiate or collectively bargain. Therefore, there are many complications involved in pulling these sufferers out from bondage. To this end, the ILO supports the government of Pakistan to fulfill its international and national commitments. In response to which, the government has ratified the 8 core conventions of the ILO, including Section 29 and 105 on forced and compulsory labour.
इस सिलसिले में गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पंजाब ने काफ़ी इनिशिएटिव्स लिए हैं. गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पंजाब ने बॉन्डेड लेबर एक्ट 1992 की प्रोमलगेशंस के बाद फिर बॉन्डेड लेबर रूल्स जो गवर्नमेंट ऑफ पंजाब ने इन्फोर्स किए हैं, उसमें हर ज़िले में डिस्ट्रिक्ट विजिलेंस कमेटी मौजूद है, जो कि कोई अगर कोई इस तरह की शिकायत करता है बॉन्डेड लेबर की या बॉन्डेज की तो वो उसको टेकअप करती है. अब तक हमारे यहाँ पिछले 15-16 सालों में मुश्किल से 200-250 केसेस हैं जो डिस्ट्रिक्ट विजिलेंस कमेटीज़ को प्रेजेंट हुए हैं, जिन पे डीवीसीज़ ने उनको हैंडल भी किया है. क्योंकि डीवीसीज़ में मैं आपको बता दूं, उसमें तीनों ट्राइपार्टाइट रिप्रेजेंटेशन है, गवर्नमेंट की रिप्रेजेंटेटिव भी हैं, एम्प्लॉयर की भी हैं और एम्प्लॉयज़ की भी हैं. तो उसको उन्होंने टेकअप करके उनको रिजॉल्व किया है और अभी भी जो मीटिंग उनकी रेगुलरली होती है हर माह या दो माह के बाद, उसमें उनको लिया जाता है और कोशिश की जाती है कि कोई इस तरह का प्रॉब्लम ना हो वर्कर्स के लिए.
ILO is a tripartite organization striving to achieve social justice through collaborative mechanism with government, employers and workers organizations. The problem of forced labor has long been veiled, but over time there has been increased recognition of the issue by the government.
In Pakistan, ILO is implementing a decent work country program which has been agreed by ILO's tripartite constituent, the Ministry of Labor, Employers Federation of Pakistan and Pakistan Workers Federation. The decent work country program has many priorities, and one of the priority is to work on the issue of bonded labor. This particular project promoting the elimination of bonded labor within Pakistan is one such effort of ILO to help our constituents to target and address the issue of bonded labor across the 4 provinces in Pakistan.
The ILO ensures decent work through its technical assistance to Pakistan through the 4 strategic objectives, including promotion and realization of fundamental principles and rights at work, creating greater opportunities for women and men to secure decent employment and income, enhancing the coverage and effectiveness of social protection for all, strengthening tripartism and social dialogue. Through concerted efforts of its tripartite constituents and other social partners, including NGOs, it has made a significant impact in bringing the forced labor issue to the fore.
One of the major initiatives that can be taken to start with as we attempt to address the issues of bonded labor is that there is a model, there is a contract developed between the employer and the employees in the Brick Kiln and such other vital sectors where contract bonded labor is visible, where the terms and conditions of employment and the rights and obligations of the parties are documented, and that will create a realization among the employers that they would not be mishandled by these middlemen, who at this point of time in fact are moving around with a team of illiterate underaged workers and provide the only source of manpower to these small and medium industry owners, and therefore are in a position to exploit the situation.
In 2001, a National Steering Committee on Bonded Labour was constituted. It was mandated to review and monitor the implementation of law and action plan and the effective working of the District Vigilance Committee.
The Vigilance Committee could only be effective if the labour the administrator should know what are the law for elimination of bonded labor and child labor act and also have the political will to enforce them and to bring out of the influential landlords and the employer the workers who are under the bondage, to free them, get them free, and to also the economic and social resources where they could rehabilitate them into some alternative productive employment. And the workers should also, and the civil society should be, have also more representation in those areas, and they should also provide not only legal assistance but also economic and social input to the victim of the bond labor.
Because of the continuous efforts of the government, legal aid services units were established in Punjab and NWFP and funded from the Fund for Children Education and Rehabilitation of Bonded Laborers. The Review of Bonded Labor System Abolition Act 1992 is a firm proof of the state's commitment to the total eradication of this years-old practice of slavery.
There are two aspects of that law. One is its substantive part, other is its practical part, enforcement. In substantive part, the definition is a very difficult one. Plus, there is a custom usage. People gave advances, loans. The law strictly prohibits it. The offenses are bailable. That means even the police can take bail as a matter of routine. The offenses are triable by special magistrates. If the government does not appoint those magistrates, the case is not followed, then all that law and its mechanism, enforcement mechanism, was devolved on an office called district magistrate, the deputy commissioner. In 2002 in Pakistan, we had a radical reforms in our administration. The office of the district magistrate and deputy commissioner was dissolved. They're no more there. So practically, the law is redundant. So these are the things which need to be updated and amended.
Under this project of ILO, PEBLIP, we have provided technical assistance to Ministry of Labour, and Ministry of Labour has carried out one tripartite consultation to review the Bonded Labour System Abolition Act 1992. In this regard, various suggestions from employers and workers and other stakeholders have been made available to the government of Pakistan. We hope that soon government and Ministry of Labour will incorporate these suggestions within the new Bonded Labour legislation.
ILO and government of Pakistan emphasized on dealing with the problem through a practical and long-term holistic approach that addresses, consequent to continuous advocacy, a national policy and plan of action on bonded labor, NPPABL, came about in 2001 that called for the effective implementation of the national policy on bonded labor. The ILO has trained district management on their functions vis-a-vis operationalization of NPPA.
They have greatly educated me, and as a member of the, as a future officer of the Police Service of Pakistan, I would like to say that, yes, I've come to know that laws have existed in Pakistan. But the real problem that lies with labor issues, with the different stakeholders, is the implementation of these laws. And that is the area which I believe, in my opinion, needs to be addressed.
I believe it's a very useful program. For the last 2 or 3 years, we are having it in collaboration with the ILO. The basic purpose is to sensitize these officers and also to enhance their capacity regarding these issues concerning labor. And I personally believe that these officers will be performing leadership role in different areas.
One of the key intervention under the PEBLIP project has been to provide a technical assistance to various government, state functionaries, training institutions across Pakistan, a facility to build the capacity of young officers. In this regard, I would like to mention the technical assistance which this project has provided to Civil Services Academy in Lahore. The idea was that young probationers who enter the government service and who are the future policy maker and the policy implementer, they are being sensitized and oriented on various forms and practices of bonded labor which are prevalent in Pakistan, and also to make them aware about government of Pakistan's international commitment under ILO Convention on Bonded Labor and how those commitments need to be honored through national legislation and policies and program. And these various batches of these probationers have received these orientations. And this is one of the very, we think, you know, the best practices of the project.
The religious leaders responded to this problem by working with government to raise awareness about bonded labor in the communities. Imams delivered sermons during Friday prayers on how Islam detests violation of labor rights. Through the platform of these religious leaders, masses could be reached and awareness was raised on different aspects of mal-labor practices such as child labor, bonded labor, gender discrimination, amongst others.
You know, we used to make presentations on them. We used to introduce them, the fundamental human rights, universal human rights, the function of the ILO, the relevant parts from our constitution, and more so, we focused on the judgment of the Federal Sharia Court, because the ulama respect that court. And he said, well, this is a judgment wherein our superior judges and ulama have said that this law is totally in light of Islam, it should be implemented. If you don't implement, it will be violation of the fundamental principle of our Islam. So they were very happy and they showed their commitment. They made a lot of speeches, and now we have made a model sermon for them so that they can adopt it while delivering their sermons or Juma prayers or other main religious days.
The ILO has adopted a practical approach in addressing the issue of bonded labor and the fundamental rights and principles at work.
Pakistan is one of the major countries which has entered into a decent work country program on tripartite basis. Both government, employer and worker have signed a agreement with the ILO, which stipulates that the decent work should be ensured by human working condition, elimination of child labor and bond labor, and respect of the fundamental rights, and creating a developing human resources and improving the working condition and social protection to the worker. And I think these principles, if you are translated with the financial input, I think that objective could be achieved, and we are trying to push the government to follow those principles.
Project on promoting the elimination of bonded labor in Pakistan engages not just the government, who undoubtedly is the key owner of the project, but other influential segments of society like academia, media, parliamentarians and opinion makers, including the religious leaders. This has become an innovative component of the project.
And similarly, we are making some bench books, manuals, wherein we will put in all relevant laws, informations to be used by all the stakeholders, how to invoke the courts. For example, how a bonded laborer can go, where he can go, what step he, she should take. So in addition to that, we are also involved in various awareness raising campaigns targeting the common populace of Pakistan.
It was critical to engage the media, both electronic and print media, and their journalists on a discussion and dialogue on the bonded labor, because we see different ways and different forms of bonded labor practices within the country. Electronic media is very vibrant, and project has been successfully has engaged the journalists across the four provinces, and the issue of bonded labor was brought to their attention. What we have seen is, through these interactions, media has started cover the issue of bonded labor and its different form, whether it's a brick kiln, whether it's agriculture, whether it's something else. And we see various information coming on electronic and print media. I think that has been a very successful intervention by the project over these few years.
Concerted efforts are underway to help these workers organize and enable them to raise their voice for freedom of association, freedom of movement, freedom for collective bargaining and negotiation. They will have an identity and access to socio-economic and political rights.
PWF has been playing a role to create awareness in the society of various aspects of the bonded labor, and pressing upon the policy maker to not only to improve the law but enforce it, and also to help in certain cases for legal relief to them, both through executive as well as judicial. But it's a very modest and very contribution comparing with the magnitude of the problem. We continue to make struggle to improve and to strengthen our struggle in order to eliminate this evil as early as possible.
Government of Punjab is making efforts in order to cater to the educational needs of these children. Their family members are being sensitized about the future of their young generation. The PRSP is a partner with the Government of Punjab and has extended microfinance facilities to the families working in brick kilns of Lahore and Kasur. In the recent stakeholders meeting organized by the ILO, it was mutually concurred that the microfinance is the tool to economically and socially empower the poor. So far, the government has distributed 10.7 million rupees to 600 families in Kasur and Lahore. The local district and state-level functionaries are now more aware and supportive of the efforts. They are getting better organized and have a great determination to stand up to this massive problem of bonded labor.
In a responsible, civilized society, civil society must come, must attend to the problems of the bonded workers, whether they are in agriculture or they are in brick kilns, and they are in all provinces of Pakistan. So civil society should take interest in them. They should lobby on their behalf. They should ensure that the vigilance committees are working, and they should also ensure that when they are in trouble, they should be helped.
A true socio-economic development cannot be achieved without considering the women empowerment and gender mainstreaming in all aspects of life. ILO and key partners prioritize this dimension and have organized training for women to gain and improve employable skills. ILO's work has given a hope to Naseem that her children would not be in the same situation in which their parents are surviving today. Her children are getting education, which surely makes them aware and provides opportunity to build their careers in decent professions other than guilds.
ਨਹੀਂ ਜੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਤੇ ਨਹੀਂ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਸਾਡੀ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਹੋਣਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਤੇ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਆ ਵੀ ਉਹ ਕਿਤੇ ਬਾਊ ਬਣਨ ਪਾਦਰੀ ਬਣਨ ਕਿਤੇ ਨੌਕਰੀਆਂ ਤੇ ਲੱਗਣ ਅਸੀਂ ਤੇ ਬੜੀ ਖਾਸ਼ ਮਾਪੇ ਨੂੰ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ.
This determination is a hope, an aspiration to make a change in the mindsets of people in the brick kiln industry. The change that promises the bonded ones an ultimate escape from the trap of debt bondage.